It has been a minute, I do believe, but I just woke up from a nap. My hair is everywhere, and totally everywhere. But amen, I promised the Lord that I would come before you tonight to encourage you. It has been a wild ride. I don't think I've been online since the tornado hit our house. We had three trees to come down. And well, let's go into prayer first, and then I'm gonna hopefully encourage you. And yeah, Father, I just thank you for this moment, God. I thank you.
And that faith
through your grace, through your heart and your hope in us, the hope of glory in us, will allow us to prevail, will allow us to be steadfast in our calling. I thank you, Father, for this opportunity.
Truth,
lead us to justice
and righteousness as this message goes forth.
May all honor and glory be given in your name.
In the name that's above every name.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen and amen. Amen. So,
like I said, I had promised God that I would come before you. I just woke up from a nap, and God is just so good. I think it's been a little over a week or so. During a tornado, three trees hit our house, and you know, so we've been,
you know, working through that
and all of that and stuff like that. And it's just so interesting. It's just like as soon as you get a good momentum, you know, things happen. But you know, God is so faithful. He is just so faithful through it all. And you know, I was just like, okay, Lord, I would definitely, you know, he's been releasing so many words and dreams and everything. And I just said, you know, Lord, at least I'll go online and pray, you know, and pray for the people and stuff. And oh my gosh, he started reciting the Declaration of Independence. And I went and I opened my journal to write the message. And I was like, oh my gosh. I hear you, so I'm just going to release what the Lord says. Good evening. And again, we know about the Declaration of Independence and how powerful it is and over our nation, you know, America and everything. And God's heart, he's still saying America will be saved. He still has hope in restoration, even though things look so divided. And just, you know, we can all have opinions and things like that, but the truth of the Lord, you know, shall prevail and everything. And so it is a message of hope, you know, that, you know, everything is still, you know, on the Lord's heart for us, for our families, for our hopes and our dreams, that he has purpose for us, you know. He gave me 1 Corinthians 1:13, and this is where, you know, the church of Corinth, they were divided. You know, they were like, who's a follower of Peter, who's a follower of, you know, who got baptized by Peter or Apollos and things like that. So the church, you know, that supposed, they started out as one, right? And all of a sudden, it was just so much division and things like that. And God is like, I haven't called you to that. I have not called you to that. Those that have my heart, those that truly know who I am, walk in love. You know, they truly walk in love. God has been saying over and over again to me, You know, you can have the power of prophecy. You know, you can speak prophecy. You can, walk in different giftings and things like that, you know. But again, if you don't have love in your heart for people, you're clanging cymbals. It doesn't matter what position you hold. It doesn't matter how much money you have. And again, God is talking to the church. He's not talking to people that don't know God, that they don't know the truth. You know, they haven't been privy just yet for the truth. I'm not holding my ears like everywhere. But that's not going to be a distraction. And, you know, so we can have titles and degrees
and everything behind
our names, but at the end of the day, God wants to know, you know, who are we, or what are we choosing to represent?
And are we choosing to represent
the true kingdom of
God that's
built on, you know, righteousness, it's built on joy, and it's built on peace.
It's, you know, it's truly built on,
you know, love, because again, love covers a multitude of sin, and when you don't have love, you have nothing. And I'm not talking about, you know, again, not standing in truth and everything like that. I am truly talking about the love that you can only get through the union
of being with Christ,
allowing Christ to put you all back together, allowing Christ, you know, daily to speak destiny into
your life. That's why God
says to, you know, his word. Well, he is his word, you know.
His word became flesh and it dwelt among
the stuff, you know. It's living, it's breathing. So that's on the heart of God. We're still, you know, even in church today, you know, God was pouring out his love so much. He was pouring out his love so much. And it just gives a whole new meaning when God says when we're weak, he's strong within us, because, you know, we were not meant to go through the things that we go through. God created a perfect man, a perfect world and everything, you know, through
Jesus. But, you know, Adam,
you know, basically forfeited the promise, but then Jesus died and brought it all back, you know, full circle for us. So we have to learn, I feel, through God's love and through his sanctification, through his Holy Spirit,
how to truly live in a kingdom
realm. How to truly live in our identity, you know. And, you know, God has been talking about faith and faith to believe.
And, you know, no matter,
you know, we say what it looks like, but, you know, Hebrews 11 is the great chapter of faith, you know, and faith being the things,
you know, unseen,
you know, the things that we hope for, the things that penetrate our hearts to give us passion, to allow us to withstand persecutions, and most time, again, you know, from the people that we love and the people that we trust and the people that we look for acceptance and everything. I mean, the body of Christ, you know, and this is what Paul was saying here, you know. I'll read it right quick.
Let's see here. So it's 1 Corinthians.
Let me ask you, is Christ divided up into groups? Did I die on the cross for you? At your baptism, did you pledge yourself to follow Paul? So,
what he's saying here, when we gave our life, you know, Jesus is always knocking. Weak enough.
And when I mean there, meaning the humility to receive. receive love that bankrupt heaven, to receive
everything he died for when we
came to the realization that everything we thought we knew we really didn't know, every moment we've spent away from Christ, from the love of Christ, from our true identity,
it's basically, you know, been living
in sin, been living in denial of our true identity, you know. So once we received
Christ in our heart
and everything, what Paul was saying here, it wasn't man, it wasn't Peter, it wasn't Paul, it wasn't Apollos, that you were baptized in the name. You were baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And again, those that are led by the Spirit are, you know, sons and daughters of God. And God is saying, stop letting division divide us. Stop letting, you know, this group and that group divide us. It's so
time for us
to fall at the feet of Jesus, to lift up the
cross, to walk in clarity.
Ultimate pearl, the ultimate field that's so precious, you know, that his blood was shed for. And, you know, I'm not being naive, I'm not being anything
but truthful,
trying to show and share the heart of God and how God sees us and how God wants us to walk uprightly before him, you know, before it's too late, you know. So many people are dying, and, you know, even, you know, not even talking about COVID or anything, but it's so much despair, and suicide is up. Oh my gosh, you know, people having heart attacks and everything. You don't know when your soul is going to be, you know, redeemed. It's kind of like the rich man that was building up barns and treasures, and he didn't realize that his soul was going to be called that night, you know? So we don't know. You don't know. And it's time to get right. God says, how can you say you love me when you don't love your brother and sisters, you know, that you see every day? You know, ask yourself, am I being the light? Am I truly walking in the love of Christ? Or am I offended? Am I bitter? Am I angry? Am I walking in unforgiveness? And the thing of the matter is that God is so good.
He's given us the moment
right now to say no to those things, to be delivered, to be healed
and set free. You know, he wants you to
live and walk in the fulfillment of who Christ made you. You know, and there's only one way to do that, and that is to give your life to Christ, to give your life to Jesus right now. Some of you that have, you know, you pledged your life to Christ so long ago, but now you're really truly lukewarm. You're living in suspicion, you know. You're looking at people through fleshly means and giftings that don't even have anointings on them anymore. You know, the giftings are without repentance. So if you know, if God bless you with a seer anointing or laying on of hands and his son or daughter is in need, he'll use you to bring that miracle. But again, you won't even know that you know the anointing is gone and everything, you know. But that's where the person that's actually getting looking for the healing and everything should use discernment, really use discernment of who they allow to, you know, to touch and pray over them, you know. But that's a whole nother story. But what I'm saying here is that some people think that they're walking, you know, because God is still using them to deliver a word or things like that. But again, you know, truly the anointing is gone, you know, because, and you should know when the anointing is gone, because you're struggling to read the word of God, you're struggling to worship God, you're struggling you know, to be that light in everything. And I know, and I'm not saying, you know, all of us have downtime and you know, we fight against principalities and things like that, you know. So I'm not talking about that, but I'm talking about the one that truly knows that they've backslid and they're doing things and God has been warning them and things like that, you know, but still you're in leadership and you refuse
through pride to
reach out for, you know, help and prayer and everything. So that's who God is talking about. And those are the people that tend to divide and just cause, you know, division, you know. They start, you know, putting labels on things and everything. And God is saying, you know, my children, and again, I'm not talking to about the children of the world. They don't know Christ. I'm talking about those that are called by his name, those that say, Lord, Lord, you know. Those are the people I'm addressing here, and that's because that's who God is addressing here, because again, every shake and everything comes to the body of Christ first. It comes to the prophets of God, you know, first for the body of Christ and then for the world. So we have to be that example, and that's what God is saying here. We have to stand brothers and our sisters, as Christ has called us. You know, we all have paths and everything. My tribe that I'm called to may be different than your tribe and everything like that, but again, we're connected to the head of Christ, you know. We have to make the decision. Something that we know will divide us as brothers and sisters, as neighbors, as, you know, if the salt has lost its flavor, you know, what is it good for? It can't preserve anything, you know.
If it's not salty, if it's not on fire, if it's not set apart, and this hour, God is,
he's gonna shake.
He's going to purify.
Because he's looking for holiness.
He's looking for,
again, that precious pearl, that person that is not going to struggle with
God and debate and everything, but by the word of God, by because the love of Christ is
going to be just magnified through their heart, through their actions and everything, because they've
spent the time in the secret place. They've spent the time looking in the
face of Jesus.
And that's all they truly
desire, is to be
one with him. So
they can actually share
and bring healing to those that are broken, you know?
And right now, God is saying that, you know, the division and the
brokenness that we've been experiencing, by his sovereignty, he's going to bring it all
together. He's going to bring it all full circle. And,
you know, the thing is,
prophesying part, you know, he never does it how we think he's gonna do it, you know. It can be very uncomfortable at times when he steps
in to bring, you know, what's right to fruition. And but he loves when we
partner with him, you know, for it. And I think the overall message here is that he's given us a freedom.
Jesus died to give us a freedom that no man can take. We can give it away. But it's time to stand and to stand for the things of God, you know, for the sake of our families and our communities. And be wise as serpents, but harmless as doves when people that are in leadership because their hearts are bitter or
they're prideful or their you know, greed has taken
over, you know, they have motives. Report was given to me, and this is what God gave.
It was back in March, actually. And he said, freedom to stand for justice.
The ultimate truth to bring light that informs the
masses to move forward in a fundamental progression that will enable all to have a sense of ownership.
Not just a few. Move forward.
A sense of ownership that will implore pride to stand and fight in dignity for promoting the worth of the common good. To fight in dignity, to fight for truth, to fight for love, to fight for the things that matter, not false positions, not money, but a sense of purpose for everyone through the eyes of God, God's truth. Our goals as leaders should be to bring hope, leading to integrity of character
that builds upon
Again, our goals as leaders should be to bring hope, leading to integrity of character that builds upon legacies for our families, community, and our country. All of us are called as leaders. If you're a child of God, then you are a leader. You have a purpose. I'm not talking about, again, what the world sees and says. We are holy priests unto God, and it's time for us to walk in that kingdom realm, that kingdom truth. The Lord says nothing goes without punishment. The ultimate truth always prevails in and through the lives of the few and in between. Always prevails. You know, it may take a moment to work itself out, but I think we have been seeing over and over again what is happening in our country and abroad. The truth, the ultimate truth is being prevailed, and it's being prevailed in some of the highest offices, and we're seeing the deception, we're seeing everything. God is pulling back the curtain. Everything, and as kingdom ambassadors, as those that are called to serve God, to be obedient to God, he is saying now is the time, now is the time to move forward, now is the time to stand and do the things I've called you to do, because again, the legacies of our families and our community and our country depends upon it, but we have to have clean hands and good hearts. God is taking people home. You know, God is clearing because he's not coming back for a corrupt church, a corrupt bride. He wants you blameless and spotless. But the only way for you to be that way is to allow his Holy Spirit to do it in you. You don't have to do it alone. That's the beauty of everything, you know? You don't. You're not alone. You are not alone. The enemy wants you to think that you're alone and that everything is hopeless and everything, but it's not. It is so not. You know, even, you know, I was like standing in the kitchen looking at the back door, you know, when the storm and the tornado was coming in, but not one time did I feel hopeless, you know. I saw it, I heard it, I saw the trees fall and everything. Not once did I feel hopeless because I knew the promises that God had made over my life and over my family's life and how he's allowed me to see the grandbabies yet to be born and things like that, you know. So I stood in my authority to pray, you know. And to trust him, to have faith, you know, and that's what God is calling us to and wanting us to do. The Lord says, stop building fortresses that alienate the progression of freedom of your mind. So stop building up fortresses in your mind. That means lies and deception and things that we've allowed to have people build up in our mind that stunts our growth. It keeps us from moving forward, you know. It makes us stagnant. It you know, it makes us feel like we're powerless and then we just stand still and don't do anything, or we just go into our church buildings and close the doors and just worry about what's inside the building. And God says, no, stop building up fortresses that divide. Come to me through my word. Call out to me. Call out to Jesus. Call out for my Holy Spirit. Thank you. I got Alexa programmed at 9 o'clock that it's time to spend time with Jesus right before I go to bed. Thank you, Alexa. She's worth something, I tell you. But, again, you have to be intentional, right? We have to be intentional to spend time because the cares of this world can keep us from spending, you know, time with the lifeline, you know? He's our lifeline, guys. He's our lifeline. And, but again, let's stop building fortresses that divide us. You know, through God's love, let's come together. The Lord says, can we not stand together in order to see the coming of our Lord and Savior in and through the freedoms that are our inalienable rights? Commonwealth can never stand without sincerity of heart, sold out for the love of his brothers. Be guided this day in the fundamental truth of justice, righteousness, and for justice and the righteousness for all. And he said, America will be saved. America will be saved. So let's not just think that everything is just, you know, that the baby's been thrown out with the bathwater, you know. Let's not think that all hope is lost, because it's not. God loves us. God has empowered us and God has called us. And even though there's still some things to come to shake this world, to shake us, to get us positioned, finally positioned where he can truly use us, you know, according to his divine purpose, you know, to bring hope, to bring love, to bring
healing to the masses so people can know
the love of Jesus. Yeah. So, Father, we just thank you. see those that read without understanding, that see without truly seeing.
Posture of the heart, the gateway of love.
Through the heart of Christ, that truth truly prevails and truly hits the mark. You take us back to the cross.
You take us back to the cross. The nail scar.
And they crowned you with thorns for us.
We do it out of reverence. We do it out of
being true to our souls, God. Being true to our Maker. We don't want to be the ones that are divided, God, that are far from you first and foremost.
With your people, we want to be trusted with your love for
your people. We want to be trusted, God, to be used. We want to be trusted with your all. Oaks of righteousness set apart for the master's table.
Used only for your glory, only for your glory, God.
There's so many that are hurting.
They don't know who you are.
And even though it's been a long road to get to the point
that we are,
progression, there's freedom and in through Jesus, and to keep moving forward, to keep taking down the giants. It's only through us, it's only through us, our lives, our actions, that they'll be able to see. Let us see people rightly, God. Let us see people rightly. Even when we're faithful.
Oh.
Even when we are
faithful, we know, Father, it's through your grace. From you.
Let us not boast in ourselves. Let us not boast in ourselves, but boast in the power of your Holy Spirit that works through us, that works within us. want a partner with you. We want to glorify you. We want to sing with you.
We want to believe
the things that you
believe. The things that you've said are true. So you
could truly use them. Give us hearts of
compassion and
understand. Strengthen your people,
God. Strengthen your people.
If nothing else is hurt
tonight, do matter.
And that the cross
of Jesus, the cross of Calvary,
is their one ticket. Their one ticket to an eternal glory.
That is so beautiful. That is so majestic. Imagine that this world can offer.
So that the division,
and if there's a division,
let it be the wheat
from the chaff.
So Jesus can get his glory, so
Jesus can get everything that
is due and everything that was
promised to him. Through us.
Holy Spirit, as you pour out fresh living water to cleanse the unrighteousness that's amongst us, that's trying to contaminate our world.
They may glorify you in the name of Jesus.
For the sake of Jesus. Heal the hearts of our land, God. Heal the hearts of our land. I ask for
a beacon of hope, a beacon of each heart right now, God. Each heart.
Even if we don't fully understand the hope of our calling, which should be in you. But even if we don't fully
understand, you plant that seed and you breathe on that seed. You water that seed for the sake of Jesus. We honor
our Lord. Father, we thank you. The new beginnings, the rest
restoration, for clarity. For those who have truly that truly beset you. That you have.
Wicked brothers and sisters, let them go, let them go.
They're
not worth your destiny. They're not
worth who he's made you to be.
They're small in
comparison to the things he's called you to be.
And the blessings he wanted to bestow on you. He said he knows it hurts. He knows.
He was right there. The Lord.
Take the plank out of your own eye.
It says,
before you take the plank out of your
brothers and sisters,
take the plank out
of your own eye.
Stop bringing division. Stand in the love I've called you. Allow my sovereignty to bring justice and correction. I need you to be my handmaid. I need you
to have clean hands and pure hearts, to be my hands and feet.
Allow my
spirit to move and to breathe.
And to bring light to the
chaos in people's lives. The cross is the measure of faith. The cross is the hope and the love
that will bring people to repentance. My goodness, my love.
Everything that I did.
So you can rest.
You can walk.
Untethered in the love of Christ.
For your brothers and sisters. Days are before you. Your best days are before you.
The Lord says he loves us.
He loves us, and
he's gonna bring restoration to our families. He's gonna be hope in the hearts of his children. He's gonna bring joy, unspeakable joy, to the hearts of his children. You shall see the glory of the Lord in the land of the living. Somebody needs to hear that. Don't give up. God says, don't give up. You've come too far to give up now. He's holding you. He's holding you. Somebody's like on the edge. Trust God. Trust God. Trust God. Right now. The name Janet. The abuses are gonna stop. God is, he's setting up a stand that the abuses will
stop.
Thank you, Father, in Jesus'
name.
Help is on the way.
God says, help is on the way. Big.
Step out on the promises he's placed
in your heart.
He has it all worked out. Yeah. Just like you told me.
Stand on Hebrews 11.
11, 1 through
4. The faith of God.
The faith of God. He's faithful. He's faithful. He's faithful.
And